Good afternoon, dear children. How are you all? I hope you all are very excellent and safe at home. Today we will see grammar lesson, and in the grammar we'll see lesson number 12, active voice and passive voice. All the grammar parts are actually really very important. In this, voices, that is active voice and the passive voice, is also very important, because this again in the next year, then again till 12th standard, if you go, active voice and passive, that is voices, are there for you. So today the very basic for very in small this one we will see in this class, the active voice and passive voice. In this lesson, before we start this lesson, we must understand that what is subject, object and verb. Already we have learned in the previous lesson that what is subject, what is verb and what is object. Here we will not see in detail. So, but before we go to the main lesson, we'll see what is subject. Okay, subject means name, naming word in that sentence. Noun is a subject. Okay, verb is a action word. Verb is action word. Okay, in that sentence, that place action, that is a verb, and the remaining part is from that sentence is we call that object. We'll see one example in this. Mona celebrates her birthday. Mona celebrates her birthday. So which is subject here, which is noun here, which is naming word is here? Yes, dear children, Mona is a naming word here. So Mona is a subject. Which is action, what she does? She, which is action word in that? She celebrates. So celebrates is a verb. Celebrates is verb, and the other part of that is her birthday, that is object. So once if you could find out which is subject, object and verb, then it is very important, very easy to do all these things, because this is very basic thing. So in this active voice and passive voice, we must understand, we could differentiate which is subject, which is object and verb. Okay, now we'll come to our main topic, that is active voice and passive voice. What is mean by active, dear children? Active, I am now active. I am active in teaching. When that person or that subject is doing something, that is we call active. He is very active personality, means doing some other thing, that time, that is called active. Passive voice, exactly opposite of active voice, is a passive voice, means in that time that subject is not doing anything, that is called passive voice. Okay, in short I am saying, for the short form of that, but how you must understand that sentence is in active voice and that sentence is in passive voice. This also you can remember, when the noun is in active, that is means subject is doing something, means that is an active voice. But when that subject is not doing anything, that is called a passive voice. So what is the definition of active voice? The subject performs the action. The definition of active voice is, active voice, the subject performs the action. The subject is performing action there. That is subject. What is the structure of subject, active voice? How you will come? You must understand this also. And the other thing is also there, that is, this is the structure. Active voice structure, subject plus verb plus object. In one sentence, in suppose this sentence, if you see in this order only, not the ulta-pulta order, this order only, if subject is there, after the subject verb is there, after the verb object is there, like this sentence is called active voice. I repeat, active voice, the subject performs the action. Subject performs the action. What the subject is doing? Subject is celebrating birthday. Subject is celebrating birthday. Okay, that is active voice. Active voice, subject is performing action. And the second thing, how you will come to know that is that sentence is active voice? That means that when that's in that sentence, subject plus verb plus object in this sequence only, when that it is there in that sentence, you must understand that sentence is in active voice. We go to passive voice. In passive voice, the subject receives the action. In passive voice, ulta is the subject receives the action, is not performing any action, not performs, but receives the action. That is called a passive voice. What is that? Okay, so what will be the passive voice for this? So one thing, the second thing is there, passive voice, the second structure is when, how you will come to know that this is the subject receives the action. Or the second thing, in the, if you see that sentence, object plus helping verb. Helping verb is am, are, have, has, was, were. When this helping verb plus V3 form, we have learned in the previous lesson, dear children. Okay, so V3 form, write, wrote, written, V3 form, play, played, played. Okay, in this way, V3 form, that verbs V3 form comes always in passive voice. Object plus helping verb plus V3 form plus by. In passive voice, whenever in the active voice and passive voices lesson, in the active voice and the passive voice lesson, when you see by by in that sentence, you must understand that sentence is in passive voice. That sentence is in passive voice. So that is the structure here. Object plus helping verb plus V3 form is there, and by, and then the subject will come. Last subject will come. Okay, means exactly opposite of, see here, active voice structure is subject, verb, object. But in the passive voice, object plus helping verb plus V3 plus by and plus subject. See, I have written, given here arrow. In the passive voice, when sentence come in the active voice, you have to do in this way. Means object will come first, then helping verb, then V3, then by, and the last will subject will come. When we say that he change the active voice into the passive voice, we have to change in this way. That we will see the sentences examples, you will come to know very clearly. And if the sentence is in passive voice, and if we are telling you to do that sentence in active voice, so structure must be like this only. Vice versa. Okay, if the sentence comes passive voice, we have to do active voice in this way. If the sentence is in active voice, you have to do the passive voice in this way. Okay, now here what will come here? What will be here as active? This is active voice. Okay, this is active voice sentence. How you will come to know that is the active voice sentence? Because there is a subject, verb, object, there is no by, by, by is not there. That is very important. Helping verb is also not there. Okay, so by is there. In short, you must know that whenever in the sentence by is there, that is a passive voice. So this is an active voice. So how you will do in that that sentence in the passive voice? So what will be the structure here? The structure is object. What will be the object here? What is the object here? Her birthday is object. Her birthday is object. Okay, should I write over here? Means you will come to know. Her birthday. Suppose now we have to do, this is active voice, we have to do in a passive voice. Okay, so object will come first. Which is object? This is object. Means her birthday. So what will be the sentence? Her birthday. Okay, then what will helping verb? Her birthday celebrates. Whenever we are writing as with verb, that sentence is in present tense, very simple present tense. So this is a s is there, so it is in present tense. So which helping verb will be there? Is, because Mona is alone there, so is will be there. So her birthday is helping verb, we have written is. Okay, then what will be the v3 form? What v3 form kiska karna hai? V3 form means verb. V3 verb ka third form. Okay, verb ka third form. So verb kaun sa isme? Celebrates. Celebrates v3 form. Celebrate, celebrated, v3 form. So celebrated, v3 form, celebrated, celebrated, celebrated. Then what is there after v3? What we have to write? By, we have to write. So celebrated by, then the subject will come. Which is subject over here? Mona is a subject here. Mona is subject here. So her birthday is celebrated by Mona. I repeat, dear children, we are going to be seeing again few examples, but see how it is there. Again, I repeat all the things. In the active voice and passive voice, you must understand that which is subject, verb and object. First you clear that. That is the first step to understand, identify subject, verb and object. Okay, then you keep in the structure in mind, how you will come to know that sentence is in active voice or that sentence is in passive voice. Subject, this is subject, verb, object in the sentence. When in this sequence only the subject, verb, object come, that is active voice. That the another definition is active voice, the subject performs the action. There the subject is performing, active hai, wo celebrating kar rahi hai, celebrates hai. Okay, that is. And the second thing is, when in that sentence by is there, v3 form, helping verb is there, that sentence is a passive voice. In this way, when object plus helping verb means what? Is, am, are in the present tense, was, were in past tense, has, have in present perfect tense, had in past tense. These are the helping verbs. Okay, so object plus helping verb plus v3 form, v1, v2, v3, that is a v3 form, you must write by and the subject. Okay, so we have seen this example, that is Mona celebrates her birthday. Now we have divided this sentence in subject, verb, identify. So we have identified. So in the past, this sentence is in active voice, we have to do in the passive voice. We have to do in a passive voice. So what will be the passive voice? The passive voice, then object will be first. The object will be first. What is that object? Her birthday is object. So we have written here her birthday. We have written here her birthday, object likh diya. What is second? Second is helping verb. Helping verb. So this sentence is in present tense. And here Mona is a singular, so we have written here is helping verb, we have written here is. You will say, why you have not written was? Because that sentence is not in a, that a verb is in a present tense. So we have written is. Okay, and after the helping verb, what is there? V3 is there. V3, kiska V3? Verb ka V3. Here celebrates is there, celebrated. V3 form is celebrated. So is celebrated. By must be there. So we have written here by. We have written here by. And the last is what we are writing? Subject. So subject is a Mona. So we have written here Mona. Clear, dear children? This is, now we'll go to our sentences. Clear sentences means you will come to know that. Few more examples we'll see, then you will come to know again very clearly. In a active voice and passive voice. Dear children, keep in mind you have to see subject, see here, subject into object. When subject, ye jo subject hai, if the name is there, you write name only. But in this subject place, yadi pronoun aata hai, if the pronoun comes, pronoun, what is the definition of pronoun? Pronoun we always use instead of noun. Now suppose I am saying that Rohit is absent because he was ill. Rohit is absent because he, we are using that he for whom? For Rohit. That is called pronoun. So in the subject place, in the active voice, when the subject place, if pronoun comes, you have to make changes in this way. I repeat, in the active voice sentence, in the active voice, in the subject place, if pronoun comes, when you are changing into object, you have to change. If there is I, it will come, that it will change into me. When it comes he, it will change into him. She will change into her. We will change into us. They will change into them. Okay, this you keep in mind. When subject comes in the instead of main noun, when pronoun comes, we have to change in this way. Now we'll see. See, to change the verb active voice into passive voice, we are changing active voice into passive voice. Okay, into passive voice. I say, first of all, you have to identify the subject, verb and object. So this is the first sentence. Pratik broke the glass. Which is subject? Pratik is subject. Broke, action word, is a verb. The glass is object. Clear? Go to second sentence. My father loves me. My father, this sentence is in active. By is not there, helping verb is not there, it's very easy to understand. So which is subject? My father is a subject, loves, verb, me, object. Me, object. Understand? Whenever in the subject I comes, object mein me hi aata hai. Okay? There in the subject me never writes, I. Okay, go to third sentence. He writes a letter. He, subject, writes, action word, that is a verb, a letter is object. What we are doing, dear children? We are identifying subject, verb, object. That is very important. You must identify clear that ki which is subject, which is verb, which is object. Fourth one, the same we have taken. I have taken the verb, this only I have taken this here. Mona celebrates her birthday. Mona, subject, celebrates, verb, her birthday, object. Her birthday, object. Her birthday is celebrated, sorry, over, we have identified. Now, we'll go to, we'll do passive voice. Keep in mind, passive voice, if you will get practice, no need to see all these things always. But till you get practice, you must see what must come there in the passive voice. In the passive voice and active voice, mein kya aata hai? Passive voice mein, object first, then helping verb, then V3 form, then why, and then subject. Okay, so what will become? So, help. Object will come first. Keep this. This you keep in front of you. This you keep. Object, I have taken object. This object I have taken here. The glass. Okay. I have taken the glass here. Object, maine yahan le liya. Object. Okay. Now helping verb. Helping verb, I have taken was. Why I have taken was? Yes, you are very clever. Because broke. Break, broke, broken. That is past tense. This is in the past tense. So the helping verb I have taken was. Helping verb I have taken was here. So after this object we have taken helping verb. Then V3 form. Subject ka V3. That is subject ka V3. Broke. Broken. So here I have taken broken. Then the third, which is there? By. So I have written there by. And the subject, which is subject here? See, here the last is subject. Which is subject here? Subject is Pratik. Subject is Pratik. So in the passive voice, sentence will be like, sentence is like this. The glass was broken by Pratik. Very easy, dear children. But you need only practice. We'll go to second. We have already identified the subject, verb, object. So what will be there? Me. Me is there. Where is me here? Me in the object. So vice versa, what will come in the subject? I. Okay, me will not come there. This me will not be here, because this is a vice versa, subject into object, when the subject is in a pronoun. Okay, so I, me. Me here kya hai? Object mein hai. Magar jab wo subject mein chale jayega, that will become I. So here I. Helping verb. Helping verb is, am, are in the present tense, was, were in the past tense, has, have in the present perfect tense. Like this way you have to write. So helping verb I have written am. With I always must write am only. Okay, I ke saath am hi aata hai helping verb. Okay, so I am in present tense. Okay, I am, helping verb is am. Now V3 form, loves it. So what will be the V3 form? Love, loved. So V3 form is loved. Then the by, we have written by. Then subject is my father. I think so, very clear. Are you clear? Okay, we'll go to third sentence. That is, he writes, we have identified the subject, verb, object. He writes a letter. Subject, verb, object. Then kya aayega sabse pehle? What will come first? Object. Come to the object, take a object. Object I have taken here, a letter. Helping verb I have taken is. Why I have taken is? Because here writes with verb, I have written s there. S means present tense. So here will come is. Is helping verb. Then V3 form. Kiska V3 form? Again I am saying write. Write, wrote, written. So helping verb will what? Written. Is written. By to rehta hi hai. Fir. Not me. Oh, he likha hai. By he. What will be dikha? He, him. So answer will be not me, but here by subject is he na. So what will come? Him. So him. This is passive voice. Okay, the last sentence, that Mona celebrates her birthday. The her birthday object I have taken first. Then helping verb is, because the sentence is in present tense. Celebrate, V3 form, celebrated. By, it will be there. So by whom? By Mona. Subject is there. I think so, dear children. It's very, very clear how to change this active voice into passive voice. Revise the lesson, see the lesson very carefully, go through the topic, open your textbook, see and try to solve those questions. In the next lecture or in the next, we will see, in the next lecture, we will see how to change into passive voice to active voice. Okay, here we have done active voice to passive voice. In the next lecture, we'll see passive voice to active voice. So, I hope you understood this lesson very clearly. Revise the lesson once again. Thank you and have a nice day.